All right, good morning, good morning. Happy Monday to you all. Got a couple of stocks gapping up. Caterpillar has a nice gap up from 161 this morning. So we'll see how it opens up, if it can hold that gap. Should be a play to the long side, as well as Kohl's. Guess they had some good holiday sales last year, Christmas holiday, Thanksgiving holiday. So they're gapping up as well. VUZI. Anything up above this 950 area will be a play for me. There goes the bell. Also, MYSZ. Anything up above 264, if it can hold that level with increased volume, I will get into this as well. And looks like SPCB is falling hard. Has to find a level of support. If it breaks below this 430, I won't even worry about it. And NVIDIA gapped up. It's pulling back a little bit right now, so it needs to break above 221. I'll take a long play on it. So that's it for right now. Let's be patient. Wait for the right setup. All right, so I'm gonna grab some NVIDIA right here, 221. Feel me, 221.42. I'll put my stop at the open, which is 220. We had this big bottom tail on this first 5 minute candle. Let you know sellers couldn't keep the stock down. Buyers start to step back in. Boom, got the pop. So that's NVIDIA. Only have let me move this up here. I have 200 shares of NVIDIA, so I won't be taking any alpha. I'll just let it run. I'm long from 221.42. Good, looking good. So my first target be 223. NVIDIA, if you hit 223, I'll sell half. Matter of fact, hit 223, I'll just go ahead and close it out. I can sell half, I'll just close it out. Take the $2. Keep it moving. NVIDIA, 278. 222.78. 222.90. And I'll flatten out right here, 230. Looks like we have some support right here on MYSZ at 240. So if this stock can break above this 265 level with increased volume, we'll take a trade on it. Right, so I'll flatten out in the NVIDIA at 223. So that's 316 on it. So that was a great trade. Stock pushed lower on the first minute candle. Buyer stepped back in, took the candle above the break of the open, got in long, stock broke above this pre-market high, volume continued to increase. As volume continued to increase, I sold at 223. So that's NVIDIA. And like I said, that was a small share size, only 200 shares. So you know, you can make money with small shares. You just have to trade smart, you know, trade stocks that are actually going to move, like the NVIDIAs, the Amazons, the Pricelines, you know, stocks like that that are going to move. Yeah, I might take this Macy's short. I think it just broke back through the open. It did. Grab some Macy's short, get 2,000 shares, got a double top up here. Move some of these lines, these are old drawings. Rough right here, edit 2453. Alright, so we got a close to a morning M pattern. Double top, one push right here, one push right here, which is a lower high. So I'm gonna try to ride this last leg down. See if it can break below this $24 area. Yesterday's close is around 24.46. Let's ride that short. Stock also broke back through the open, which is a sign of weakness. And I want to be short. Anything breaks back through the open, I want to be short. She goes. There's Macy still showing weakness. Continue to hold this stop short. I think yesterday, well not yesterday, but Friday's close was 24.48. So we broke through Friday's close. And my target's down here. 24 bucks, 2,000 shares. So make 50 cents on 2,000 shares. That's great. And all you had to do is recognize the pattern. You got a double top or M, more or less of an M than a double top, since they're not, you know, not that quite equal. Boom, boom, boom. Ride that second leg down. There's Macy's at 24.16. I got my target right here at 24 even. Caterpillar has found some support. Anything back above 164.12 will be in play. So Caterpillar had a gap up last from Friday from 161.88. Stock fell back. Some people took profit. I only fell back to 162, so I'm actually grab some Caterpillar. First, let me sell out this Macy's. Flatten out of Macy's at 24. Boom. All right, so flatten out of Macy's, made $1,000 on it. Short. Off the M pattern, morning M pattern, courtesy of my main man Max. And I'm gonna grab some of this Caterpillar. So I'm long Caterpillar at 164.33. This is a big candle, so we may pull back a little bit on the next candle. But should be okay. Put my stop right here at 163.26. That's my stop. First target would be 165. Now I'm long Caterpillar at 164.33. Target is 165. All right, so Caterpillar still holding up around my entry at 164.33. Well, it breaks above 164.55, I'll go ahead and move my stop up to break even. So take a look at the volume. See on these red candles, volume is decreasing. So that means less sellers were stepping in. So this area may be an area of support. Not that many people are selling up here. So MYSZ can break above this trend line. Stock could push up to $3. So we get an increase in volume with a break above this trend line. I'll take a trade on MYSZ. The support level or pre-market high level can hold right here, 265, that can hold up, be a good trade. Getting volume increasing on CAT. All right, there's CAT, 164.60. I'm gonna move my stop up to 164.33. Jump in this MYSZ. It's finally about to break through their trend line and volume is increasing. CAT's looking good. 164.70 on CAT's. And let's see. I'm going to step in some of this MYSZ. All right, so I'm in some MYSZ at 290. I've got some support down here around 264. Roughly that's 30 cents away. Let me look at it on 1 minute. That support at 270. So roughly 20 cents away. Alright, so I'll take half off at 310. I have 5,000 shares. All right, so MYSZ still looking good. Still hanging out that $3 area. CAT still hanging out, 164.70. I'll sell half of MYSZ up there at 310. Lock in 500 on it. I'm long from 290. Roughly right here on this candle is where I got in. All right, so let me sell 250. All right, so I sold 2,500 shares up there at 310. At 2,500 left, move my stop up to break even. So roughly 290 is my stop. $1,000 go up here, 325. All right, so I got $1,000 left. And I'll hold it for the first 5 minute pullback. Get that first 5 minute doji, I'll close this thing out. Or if it drops back and hits my stop, that'll be it. So I'm gonna move my stop up to 325 on this last piece. Actually, let's make it 340.
flatten out. And that'll be it for MYSZ. So that is all for MYSZ. So it was a good day. Good day, good day, good day. All right, so Caterpillar's trying to get up there. Target is this pre-market high, 165. Gets up there, try to close it out for what, about 67 cents. That's the target. See what it's gonna do. All right, there we go. More green trades for the day, that's great. Good start to the week. Be patient with your trading. Develop different setups. Don't have tunnel vision. Don't just stick with one stock. There's plenty of stocks out there to be traded, long or short. Just develop different setups. The premise of trading will always be the same. The only thing that changes is the setup. You always look for an imbalance between supply and demand. No matter if you're trading on the short side or the long side, the only thing that changes is the setup. Whether you're trading stocks that fall back through the open, trading stocks that bounce off support or bounce off resistance, or trading patterns. You know, the premise of the actual trade is the same. You're looking for imbalance between buyers and sellers. There's more buyers, you need to be buying. If there's more sellers, you need to be selling. So that's it for me today. Freedom exists not to do what you like, but having the right to do what you ought to be doing. Enjoy your trading.